Hi everyone, welcome to the first episode of Coding Bytes, Mirror Mirror on the Wall. I'm Edmund, an educator with Coding Lab, and today we are going to learn about motion and reflection. Let us take a quick preview of what we are going to learn by the end of today. In our project, we have Scratch Cat in his room. As we press on our arrow keys, Scratch Cat will be moving around in his room. There's also a mirror on the wall, and you can see Scratch Cat's reflection in the mirror. Okay, as we move closer towards the mirror, okay, Scratch Cat's reflection is coming closer to us as well. As we move away from the mirror, then you can see more of Scratch Cat's reflection. Let's give this a try. Let's click on the link in the description box down below, and we are going to start programming on Scratch Cat's movement and the reflection. All right, now that we have clicked on the link in the description box below, we are now going to remix the practice. If you notice, okay, and click around, you'll then see that only our Scratch Cat and our reflection do not have any code on it. So this is where we are going to start coding on it. We are going to first think about what happens when green flag is clicked. For our Scratch Cat, our green flag we want on green flag click, we want him to be at a certain location. Let's use 0 and negative 80. So at this current location. Then I also want him to be pointing at a certain direction. And this is our negative 90. Following which, we want to make sure that their rotation style is right. So it's going to be left, right. And my Scratch Cat is going to be the front layer. Okay, there's going to be a middle layer, which is the wall, followed by the back layer, which is our reflection. All right, so this is going to be our front layer, and we can now make him show. The next thing that we want to do is thinking about our button press. We are going to use a forever if because we want to be constantly checking if there is a key press. And which key are we looking at? Let's look at right arrow key first. When I press the right arrow key, I should be moving to the right, and therefore my X should be increasing. So I'm going to change my X. Yeah, I'm going to change it by 10, and it's going to point in the direction as well. I'm going to point to the right. Okay. Now, just to double confirm, I have two costumes, that's good, which would then mean I can say a next costume so that it looks as though I'm moving. And then we can give this a try. You will also notice that I'm moving too fast, yes? So what we want to do now is to put a wait block, okay? Wait for how long? Maybe about 0.1 seconds, okay? If you have a look at now, okay, our Scratch Cat is moving at a more constant pace now, okay? A more proper pace now. So now that we have done for our right arrow, we are going to do the same thing for our left arrow. So key left arrow press. So when we press our left arrow, we want to be moving to the left, and therefore our X should be decreasing. And we should also be pointing to the left, which is negative 90 degrees. Everything else will then stay the same. Okay. Giving a try now. Okay, there we go. Now, we also want to do for our moving up and moving down. However, when we press the up arrow, we shouldn't be changing our X anymore. We should be changing our Y. So we should be changing our Y, let's say by 10. Okay, we still want to be going to the next costume, and we still want to be waiting for 0.1 second. The rest is not needed. Okay, however, one thing to see is this. If I continue pressing up arrow, it looks as though I'm flying. Yes, it looks as though I'm flying. So what do we have to do then? We have to put, whenever we are moving upwards, we have to think of what is the maximum Y value that we want. So we are going to put our logical operator over here, which is our N. Okay, this is a maximum. Therefore, every value that we are considering is going to be lesser than. Let's put this as our maximum. All right, so we want all our Y position to be less than negative 80. All right, so Y position less than negative 80. Now, this is going to be the max highest I can go. What about the lowest I can go? So this is where I'm going to press my down arrow key, and I'm going to change my Y by negative 10. Now, the lowest I can go, which means that we are going to be comparing every value that is more than a certain value. Okay, let's put a difference of maybe 40. So if negative 80 is the maximum, then negative 120 will then be the minimum, right? So now if I give it a try, when I press down, this is the lowest I can go, and this is the highest I can go. That's good. Now that we have done the codes for our scratch cat, we are just going to bring it over to our reflection because it's quite similar. Let's look at it together. Okay, going to this location, static location, pointing at this direction. Our reflection is going to go to the back layer. When I press to the right, it's going to the right. When I press to the left, it's going to the left. However, now the only difference is this, okay? When I press the up arrow key, my reflection shouldn't be going up because this would then remove my reflection because it's in the same position as my scratch cap. When I press up, my reflection should be going down, all right? And when I press down, my reflection should be going up. Every time that we are going down, there's going to be a minimum value. Every time that we are going up, there's going to be a maximum value, all right? If the minimum value is where we are currently at, where this is negative 80, then we have to think of the maximum value, which is going to be the same difference of 40, and this is the maximum value of negative 40. When we give this a try now, this is the lowest I will go for my scratch cat, and that is the highest my reflection will go, all right? So this is how we do our program. Thank you for watching. I hope you have learned something from me today. Please like, share, and subscribe for more coding videos. Thank you, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.